Tea for Texas, snapshots of Texas history from T. Lindsey Baker.
When you think about brooms, which probably isn't too often, you don't ordinarily consider making them to be a creative act. Nevertheless, this is how Lyle Spelling Sr. of Jefferson, Texas, described them to me. He told me about them about 25 years ago at the Club Cafe on Polk Street in Jefferson. I thought it was fascinating. Lyle's career began when he was a teenager in Jefferson. I'd come home from school and do up brooms, he related. This involved trimming the tips evenly, labeling the handles, and bundling the brooms together for sale. After Lyle graduated from high school, he moved to Grand Prairie and then entered the armed forces during World War II. Then he worked in the East Texas oil field and for the post office, but none of this pulled Lyle completely away from the brooms. He commented, I've always worked weekends, evenings, and stuff like that. For Lyle Spelling's, broom making has an appeal that no other vocation can offer. I enjoy fooling with them. It's stingy work. Dust gets down your collar and you have to take a bath when you get finished, but I like it. Added to this, he found an aesthetic appeal. I enjoy seeing a broom that's made properly and looks good with good workmanship and quality corn in it. It's a creative job. You create a broom.
Tea for Texas with T. Lindsey Baker is produced by KTRL Radio at Tarleton State University in Stephenville, Texas. More information at teaforTexas.org.